In the U.S., health officials are urging Americans not to attend Super Bowl parties this weekend. There's concern the festivities could turn into super spreader events. The big game is the most watched program on American television every year. In 2020, more than 100 million people tuned in, many at bars and pubs. The U.S. is seeing a drop in new COVID-19 cases, but as Jennifer Johnson explains, experts fear that will be short-lived.
One day before the Super Bowl, fans are already gathering and cheering. But federal health officials and those on the front lines are begging Americans to stay home and avoid partying with friends, fearing this game will be another game changer in the COVID-19 pandemic.
I think it's really important that we don't have these large indoor gatherings.
In Los Angeles County, sports bars and restaurants are prohibited to have TVs in customer seating areas Sunday, even outdoors. There are also fears about private parties.
It's the Super Bowl, not the Stupid Bowl.
Don't bring multiple households together and create a super spreader event.
The National Football League is allowing about 25,000 fans to attend the game, including thousands of immunized healthcare workers. But this event will be like no other.
Every fan will have nobody seated in front of them, nobody in behind them. Restrooms, which not only have physical distancing, but touchless. It's the first ever cashless Super Bowl.
The NFL commissioner has told the Biden administration football stadiums can be used as federal mass vaccination sites. The Pentagon is deploying 1,000 soldiers to help at those sites across the country. But people with appointments continue to face cancellations and frustrations.
So I was turned away, and I'm very upset. There's a bunch of people up there with me having the same issues.
The push to vaccinate comes as new variants are spreading fast. The one that originated in South Africa is now in at least 3 states. The variant that was first detected in the UK is showing up in even small, remote cities.
This person was obviously exposed by someone else. There is this variant that is already present in Kalamazoo County.
The Biden administration is still confident it can administer 100 million doses in 100 days. Adding to the supply, Johnson & Johnson's vaccine, which is expected to receive federal approval this month, and hundreds of thousands of unused vaccines from nursing homes that are being reallocated. Hope on the horizon for Americans weary of this almost year-long pandemic. Jennifer Johnson, Global News, Washington.